Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. Today we're going to look at a bunch of confusing statements from Torben Sondergaard that show he doesn't know what he really believes. Let's jump right in. So this is from a clip called "Did You Receive the Holy Spirit When You Believed?" And he's referring to Acts 19:2 when Paul came upon some of the disciples and asked them this very question. And if we follow the complete chapter, it makes a lot more sense. They explained that they only had received the baptism of repentance through John, but they were told that they should believe in the one that would come after him, that being Christ Jesus. We also have this confirmed in Acts 8:16 that the Holy Spirit had not yet come upon any of them. In the very next verse, we also see a very unique thing happen. Peter and John laid hands and the Holy Spirit fell on them. This also happens in Acts 19. People like Torben and others in the hypercharismatic movements believe that we can still impart the Holy Spirit to people through laying of hands. Scripture shows this, though, to be a special time when there were true believers that had not yet received the Holy Spirit because Christ had not ascended yet. And these hand-picked apostles had a very unique authority in that time. This is not true today because when we are born again, we receive the Holy Spirit. We see this in verses like Ephesians 1:13 that tell us when we believed, we were sealed with the Holy Spirit. And Romans 8:9 tells us that if we don't have the Spirit of Christ, we are not God's children. So to start, we're going to look at Torben and say that based on Acts, people today can become actual believers but still not have the Holy Spirit.
Hey, good morning. I woke up this morning with a question to you. And that is, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed? This question is not just my question. It's actually a question from the Bible. When Paul came to Ephesus, you read about that in Acts 19. He met some believers and the first thing he asked them was, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed? We have seen many believers receive the Holy Spirit. Many believers being baptized with the Holy Spirit. A week ago, we baptized around 30 people in water. And while people got baptized in water, I walked around and laid hands on people and prayed for people to receive the Holy Spirit. And I want to show you one clip here of a woman who received the Holy Spirit a week ago when I laid hands on her.
And now we'll look at this prayer of his, which is for a believer that does not yet have the Holy Spirit according to him.
Say, Jesus, I need you. I repent. And I ask you, set me free. Save me.
He's saying that this person is a believer, that is, a saved person, but just doesn't have the Holy Spirit yet. But he has her do what a person does when they get saved, repentance and asking Jesus to save them. What the heck? And now he switches gears and focuses on what he's calling the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Come with your Holy Spirit. Fill me up.
Fill me.
Baptize me.
Baptize me.
Right now.
Right now.
More. Shila ba da 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 speak.
Shila say the first word I mean.
Shila da 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 get it da 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 louder. Shila da get it da 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 louder. Shila get it da 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 get it da 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 get it da 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 da.
Yeah!
Yeah! Woo!
Thank you.
It's beautiful. Come on, this is for everyone. Come on, God, you want to give the Spirit to us. Woo! Come on, this is what we should do. Go around and pray for healing, deliverance, and the Holy Spirit.
As I said before, it's for you. Don't hold back.
keep pressing through. Repent, be baptized, and shall receive. Look at that.
So he contradicts himself again. He said, believe, get baptized, and receive the Holy Spirit. Well, she didn't just get baptized to receive the Holy Spirit. In his other videos, he does baptism in water for people and then casts demons out of them, and then they speak in so-called tongues, which to him is evidence. They just received the Holy Spirit. So, if she is an actual believer, but just doesn't have the Holy Spirit, then why isn't he baptizing her for this instead? She obviously didn't already have the water baptism of John because that was during the time when Jesus' Holy Spirit was not yet available. This guy is a showman and a deceiver.
You shall receive the Holy Spirit. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. So here you can see how she received the Holy Spirit. She did not receive the Holy Spirit when she believed, but she received it later there when I lay hands on her.
So he's saying that she did believe at one point, that is, commit herself to Christ and become a new creation, as it says in 2 Corinthians, but the Holy Spirit didn't come into her. It's only because of his prayer that she received the Holy Spirit. As we saw in Romans 8:9, if you don't have the Holy Spirit in you, then you are not a child of God. It is not a separate occasion like he's falsely teaching.
There is many people out there in the world who will mock what is happening. There's people in the church who will mock what is happening. Oh, this is not real, this is not real, and what about this? And the words, we don't understand what you are saying, and it don't sound like tongues, like they know what tongues sound like.
Well, anybody with half a brain knows that his Morse code da 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 tongues is not real. And based on Acts 2:8, we do know what tongues sounds like. They heard people speaking in their own native languages. Where is Napoleon Dynamite when you need him? You don't even know what you're talking about. Gosh!
Let's forget what we have grown up in our culture, in our traditions, and then just build on the Bible and the Bible alone. What do we see in the Bible? In Acts, book of Acts, we see after the Holy Spirit was poured out on people, we see different examples of people who received the Holy Spirit. Acts 2, 120 people were scattered and the Holy Spirit came on each of them. And they later preached the gospel with boldness and even more people got baptized in water and got born again.
This is wrong. This supports his false teaching of baptismal regeneration and that you're actually not born again until you get baptized. But now he gets even more confused.
We also see in the book of Acts that there is a clear sign when people receive the Holy Spirit. The sign is that they start to speak in tongues of worship or speak in tongues of prophesy. There is a sign that they have received the Holy Spirit.
This is another type of Torben's false teachings that we've seen in other clips, that everybody will speak in tongues and prophesy when they are born again. But first, we know that tongues and prophecy are both gifts from God and that we don't all have the same gifts. And second, tongues is a sign for unbelievers, not believers. So the fact that Torben's followers speak in the same da-da-da-da nonsense when they get baptized shows it's unbiblical. If they were truly speaking in tongues, then it would be a known language and unbelievers would be amazed that someone they knew was suddenly speaking a language they didn't know. That would draw people closer to God. But this isn't what we see in Torben's movement.
Many don't like the book of Acts because they don't see that as the normal Christian life where they come from. And then they take verses out of context and just dismiss everything we read in the book of Acts. For example, Ephesians 1:13, we read that Paul, he said to the church in Ephesus, were you not sealed with the promise of God when you believed? And they said, look here, we all have the Holy Spirit when we believe.
And that is when we receive the Holy Spirit, when we believed. But we'll hear Torben say that Paul saying that was only applicable to that time and we should go back before Ephesians into the book of Acts. Ridiculous.
But you have to remember that Paul, he wrote Ephesians, letter of Ephesians, not to a Lutheran church today, not to a Catholic church, not to a Baptist church, not to your church, but to that church. And what did they do at that time when they believed? At that time, they repented, they got baptized, and they received the Holy Spirit. And therefore, Paul, he could write to them, were you not sealed with the Holy Spirit when you believed? Because when people believed at that time, it was just different than many people today when they believe. Today, there's people who come to faith without knowing about the Holy Spirit. There's people who come to faith thinking that the Holy Spirit is not for today. There's people who come to faith thinking that tongues is only for a few. There's people who come to faith and think that the gift ceases with the apostle. There's so many people out there who have different kind of belief or kind of faith. What I encourage you to is don't build on your traditions. Take the book of Acts, take the Bible and read it through. What do you see in the book of Acts? You see that people, the norm should be repent, believe, be baptized, and receive. You repent toward God, believe in Jesus Christ, and get baptized to Him. And then after you have got baptized to Him, you receive the Holy Spirit by the laying on of hands.
This guy is seriously out to lunch. In one breath, he says you get the Holy Spirit during baptism, and now it's by the laying on of hands. He goes on for another 15 minutes and teaches on speaking in tongues and speaks more of his Shila da da da, but we're going to end with just a couple more twisted scriptures.
And this is where Paul said, I speak more in tongues than anyone else. What we can also say about tongues and Paul, for example, is that Paul, he was the guy who said, imitate me as I imitate Christ. Paul, he knew Christ. We know that he knew Christ.
So he says that Paul spoke in tongues more than everyone, and that Paul said to imitate him as he imitates Christ. So we should be speaking in tongues just like Paul. Yet there is not one verse to support Jesus ever speaking in tongues, never mind even in his baptism. This is classic eisegesis and making scripture mean what you want it to mean, not what it actually means.
Tongues is very, very important. And I believe this is for everyone, everyone, everyone. And I believe when you get baptized with the Holy Spirit, you have it. Do I therefore say that those who don't speak in tongues don't have the Spirit? No, because there is people who sincere have been repenting and prayed and asked and the Spirit have come into them. But they have the Spirit, but they don't speak in tongues because of wrong teaching. They are maybe waiting for the mouth to just move by themselves, or the thing is not for today, or they have heard something else. I met many, many hundreds of people out there. When I start to pray for them, they say, I would like the Holy Spirit now, and I would like tongues, and pray for them. And when I start to pray for them, I'm like, hey, you already have it. Just open your mouth and speak.
So there's just one more false teaching of Torben against what the Bible says. Was God correct in speaking through Paul and saying that we don't all have the gift of tongues? Or is false teacher Torben right in saying that we should all have that gift? This guy focuses on one book of the Bible for the majority of his entire ministry. Anyone who cannot see that this guy is a deceiver is deceived themselves, and I pray that God would release you from him. That's it for today. As always, leave your thoughts and comments below, and until next time, take care and God bless.